Hi, I'm working on the Enchanted Forest again. It's a big project, quite a large size, probably about approximating 2 feet by 3 feet, maybe a little larger than 3 feet, probably. And right now I'm choosing materials. So this is all about choosing materials and considerations when you're choosing your materials. So I was looking, I'll try to aim the camera here. I was using this light stained glass, which I salvaged from an old lampshade that was broken, and another type of stained glass from the same lamp. And that's going well, and I'm interspersing them with flowers. And the problem is, I want the grass and back, like the ground, to go darker as I get further back. So I found these plates through someone who was giving them away very nicely, and I'm cutting them up and trying to see, this could look like a good bush for the back to where the deer is going to be popping out. I don't know if you could see the deer's head. I'm going to be getting some extra equipment at some point to be able to do better videos, so have patience with me. But for now, let me move this away so maybe you can see the deer's head better. So yeah, that's where I am right now, is just trying to see what kind of, like, the challenge with this is that they're thicker, right? So you don't want it to look like it's in front of something it shouldn't be, or in back of something it shouldn't be. So sometimes you have to cut this angle from the plate here. Actually can be very useful in this circumstance, because it looks like the deer is behind the bush, which I really like that, you know, coming out from behind the bushes. In this instance, I took a really thick textured kind of a rectangular container that I had, probably found at a yard sale or something, or maybe at my mother's, I don't know. But it's very uneven surface. So for instance, I had to think, how can I fill in the spaces after with grout and neatly clean up everything after? So I've decided what I'm going to attempt for that. Now this is all trial and error. So you're learning with me and learning from my mistakes as we go along. But I'm going to try using a pastry bag and just touching it up with a small tool or my finger in between to push down the grout later on. But right now, I'll be spending the day trying to see what materials are working and what's not, and hopefully come back with a plan. This is all what goes into making a mosaic. It's not a simple process sometimes. Okay, take care, and I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.